welcome back to Auto Repair guys. If you guys have a Dodge, Chrysler or Jeep guys and your radio speakers do not work, let's say rear speakers do not work or the front speakers do not work, we're going to explain guys what is causing that, how to fix it and how to test your speakers. So stay with us guys, thank you for watching and subscribing to the channel, let's start rolling. Now let me introduce you guys to the channel. Every Dodge Chrysler vehicle that we get, we'll make at least 200 videos on it. Every vehicle that we get in the shop. So please guys, subscribe. Our mission is to save you as much money as we can. Now we have that Dodge here and we don't get any sound in the rear guys. Okay, any sound at all. So I'm going to turn the radio on. Okay, let me show you now. The radio will come on in just a second. And you will notice, okay, I'll go to the fade as well. Okay, let me go to the fade, balance, and you're going to see, okay, it's center, everything's center. Front speakers work. The rear ones, we have two speakers, right? Two speakers, one in this door, one in the other door. Listen now. Nothing. No sound at all. Okay, I'm going to attempt to go to the other door and see what's happening there. No sound at all. Now, what is causing that? Let me turn the radio off and we're going to explain, guys. We're going to test speakers, we're going to swap speakers and demonstrate what the problem is. So, we're going to remove that speaker now, guys. Okay, we're going to remove it. We're going to remove the front one as well. We'll get both of them. And we'll explain how to test them now. So we have that voltmeter here, that's the only thing that we need. Okay, and we need to set it at ohms, to read ohms. On the back of each speaker, as you can see, there is usually a place where it says what's the resistance. This one is 4 ohms, this one is 4 ohms, identical speakers. So, if it's a good speaker, that thing should say 4, or around 4, close to 4. Right now, it just says empty, like it's not connected. So. I'm going to go ahead, okay, install the alligator clips because it's way easier. Here you just have two wires inside, so I'm going to connect each alligator clip to a wire. Okay, check out what happens. Nothing, no reading. Now, if I switch these two wires to this speaker now, you're going to notice guys that it goes close to 4, so that's a good speaker. So what we're going to do now, okay, we're going to get the good speaker and we're going to put it in the rear door, okay, and see if that heals the system now, because the radios usually they have a protection where if one speaker is blown it will deactivate the other ones so nothing burns, nothing gets shorted out. So let's check it out now. Okay, radio is coming on. Again, I'm going to go to the audio fade balance. Let me show you again that everything's like it should be. Come on, dude, wake up. Right there. And listen.
Classic hits 105.7.
Yep, everything works. So one bad speaker will cause the other speaker not to work as well.
Thanks to Dr. Jerry.
So you can see guys, this is it. Hopefully the video will be helpful to some of you. Please hit that subscribe button for more videos and see you guys next time.